Thanks in no small part to the continued efforts of our partners, the Massachusetts plover population has come a long way since the shorebird was first protected under the Endangered Species Act, from around 140 pairs in 1986 to more than 650 pairs in 2013. While the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service and MassWildlife work with many town departments, here are four examples of communities that have seen success from their careful and deliberate management of piping plovers.
We've been seeing over the years an increase in our piping plover populations, solely because of the efforts of other town departments, Audubon, and Fish and Wildlife.
That basically starts in the beginning of end of March when they come from their breeding grounds, and then they start nesting within the first couple weeks of April. Once the brood have hatched, we basically, you know, every day come out, count the chicks, record where they are, and try to keep any human disturbance at a minimum.
On a daily basis, we walk through the habitat looking for new nests, checking for hatching with old nests, signs of predation, and just checking on chicks that have hatched. So we have a management plan that lets us know what we need to do in different situations to provide or restrict recreational activity as needed.
As you see around, that we have the symbolic fencings, which keeps a visual barrier and also helps keep people from entering into the symbolic fencing. We have lots of signs that are standing that say what the fencing are for, why the birds are here. We also have plover monitors on the beach, as well as town staff, that helps to keep the beach functioning, but also have the birds protected.
A couple of the birds that came later in the season that nested in places that traditionally they haven't. That was a challenge this year to watch for the brood that was in the most perilous spot it could possibly be in. So there were a couple days after hatching that we would have to babysit the chicks for long periods of time. A lot of the beachgoers were like, oh, I never realized how small they were. Now I realize why you put the fencing up and why the efforts are as such.
A lot of people have been very curious about the birds. We've had a lot of people that come up to us and are asking, how are the birds doing? We had a pretty busy season, a pretty productive season, and it was very successful. And I think a lot of that was due to the management of the beach.
We do one-on-one contact on the beach as well. We're trying to reach out to the schools in the community. We're trying to help spread the word among the kids, give them a better understanding of what's happening on the beach. So once their parents take them out over the weekend, they actually are able to explain their parents why we have some sections of the beach fence off. We have seen this year an improvement relative to last year in acceptance, and actually we've seen a tremendous amount of success. This year the plovers fledged earlier in the season, and the reason for that is thanks to the residents and the visitors that didn't disturb them earlier in the season.
We've worked hard putting up signage, putting up information boards about the plovers and what they mean to our environment and our community. And people have become much more amenable to the fact that they're sharing this natural space.